Coach, as always, thanks for joining us from down there on the coast. We like to kind of go backward a little bit before we go forward and talk about 23. What were some of the lessons that you're carrying with you from last year that you think will help you out in this season?
Well, hope that we certainly got better as the year wore on last year. You know, we started 0-2 and lost two games we really probably shouldn't have, but we finished pretty strong and, you know, getting wins over Valdosta Lounge and then East Coweta in the playoffs. And I think our kids learned a lot with that. I think they learned that they can play with those guys again, and hopefully that'll carry over to this year.
You're entering your third season as head coach of the Wildcats. How's practice going? How's summer been? Give us a summary of everything you've seen so far.
Well, you know, it gets easier every year in terms of the more kids that are in the program that know how things work, of course. We've had a good offseason. Starting in January all the way up to now, and I'm extremely pleased with where we're at right now. We've still got a long way to go now, don't get me wrong. This time of year. But, you know, the third year is certainly easier than the first. And, you know, hopefully the results will be a little bit better as well.
And you get to do it in Region 1-7A, one of the toughest regions in this part of the world. And when you look at your schedule, because of Region 1-7A only being a handful of teams, and you have to travel from basically the coast to Moultrie for, you know, things that happen, when you look at Region 1-7A, that means you've got to come up with a boatload of non-region games. When you look at your schedule this year and how tough it is to put one together because of how small Region 1-7A is, what do you see?
Well, it's hard. It's really hard. You know, we've for the last couple of years, we've tried to play some schools out of Florida just for convenience because they're close to us and closer than Atlanta, you know. And that's been kind of mixed results because you never know with them if they're going to honor a contract or not honor a contract. And we've been back and forth with people about, you know, are they really playing us or not? But we've been kind of fortunate. You know, we've got Columbia out of Atlanta who actually beat us last year in the opening game. And Glenn and Brunswick agreed to play us the last 2 years. And that's been good rivalry. And we've actually got New Hampstead this year, which is a new addition where, you know, Coach Hockman's at, and we have good relationship there. You know, all that's before our region starts, and we do still have this year it's a two-game Florida swing, I guess you'd call it. But, you know, we've got a pretty good schedule. It gets harder as you go, I guess, you know, until you step into Region 1, there's no off weeks for sure.
With offseason comes recruiting. Tell me about a couple of your players that are getting looks and then someone who deserves an offer on your team.
Yeah, it's been a good year for that. You know, we don't have a Power Five guy, I guess you would say, you know, in this year's class. But Denigel Cooper's committed to Appalachian State.
Nice.
He's an linebacker for us. Jamarly Riddle's is committed to East Carolina. And he plays safety running back for us. And, gosh, we've actually got three kids. Two, I guess I'll say right now. Jaden Daly and Mason Robinson, who have offers from military academies. So
awesome.
We've got some smart kids that are pretty good, too. And that's always a good thing.
Since this is your second tour there in Kingsland, what I was going to ask next is about the community. And you've gotten to see how the community wraps itself around Camden County Athletics, Camden County Football. For someone who hasn't seen the hard hats, who are there in the front row for you on the home games at Gilman and see you guys on the road and how you travel and how you pack places out, how would you describe what the community is and what it means to Camden County?
You know, John, Camden's kind of it's a small town. I mean, you know, we said Camden County, but, you know, we're made up of three kind of small towns, Kingsland, Woodbine, St. Mary's. So we still just have that, you know, good old South Georgia small town feel. You know, if it wasn't for the naval base sitting here, we'd probably be playing single A or double A football, you know. And so they really, really love it. And it's been so neat to be a part of that. And it's not just football. They do it with all our sports. And, you know, things just revolve around our school and our school system. And, you know, our band and our cheerleaders and, you know, our ROTC team. I mean, they support everybody. And, you know, that's something that I did not feel in Metro Atlanta, you know, but we're fortunate in that we do have a small town atmosphere, but a big time atmosphere when it comes to athletics, because, you know, there's not a lot of other things to do on a Friday night.
Last question for you, Coach. Is there a game day superstition that you would like to share with us?
Uh-oh.
I'm not superstitious, Hannah. I'm just lucky.
Exactly.
You know, I've got a million of them. I mean, I don't know that any of them, they change though. You got to remember, you know, I don't know what kind of superstitious I am, because if something doesn't work one week and that one's out the door, then I've got a new, you know, if we're winning, I'm going to wear the same clothes. I will make sure, you know, my wife will do the laundry and I'll put those right back there so I can wear them the next Friday and all that. But, you know, We've got some things that we love to do, like from when we're at home, like, you know, leave our weight room and walk to the stadium and certain music at certain times. And that's a great one. And, you know, for me personally, the one thing that is very important to me, it always has been, is I like to get away on Friday afternoons by myself. You know, and you know, most coaches wish they had that opportunity probably, and I'm fortunate, and, you know, I'll try to get some alone time there just to kind of get myself ready. That's how I get ready for the game. And, you know, if we're on the road in a different atmosphere and I'm not able to do that, it drives me crazy. But I like to be able to have some solitude there right before we get ready to play.
Well, I mean, you could be Maurice over at Brooks, who doesn't speak to anybody on, it's like Thursday, don't call him because he's not going to speak to you. He's only going to do hand signals. And yeah. Friday, it always goes to voicemail. Literally, he doesn't talk to anybody on a Thursday.
That's funny. Thanks for sharing that, Coach.
That was awesome.
No problem.